Hello everyone, welcome at this Blender tutorial. Today I will show you how to make these wine glasses. This is my final result, so let's get started. Here we have my default scene with the default cube. First go to edit mode and hit 1 on the numpad to go to front view. Also go to wireframe mode. Hit B for border select and delete these vertices. Now with 7 on the numpad to go to top view, back to solid view, hit A to select everything and subdivide it once. Now we'll shift and deselect the middle vertice and go to mesh transform to sphere to get this shape. Now with S and scale that a bit. Like that. Go back to front view and move that down a bit. Now press E to extrude and S to scale to about this size. Also move that down a bit. Now press E and then Z to extrude along the Z axis. Like that. Do that again, like this. Now rotate your view a bit and hit S and scale that inwards, like this. Hit E to extrude along the Z axis, like that. Go back to front view and press S to scale. Like that, alright. Now with E and then Z to extrude along the Z axis. And another one. Press S to scale. Extrude again. And scale. So now we already have the shape of a wine glass. Now to make this nice and smooth, add a modifier. So go to your modifier tab, that's over here, and select subdivision surface. Now for the view use 3, and for the final render use 5. Now you can see that over here it's a bit too much curved. So to fix that we are going to use grease lines. First enable this button. Now with A to deselect everything, hit B for border select and select this area and increase this value. Like that, that looks alright. Now do some other ones. Hit A to deselect, hit B for border select and select this area. Alright, and the last one, A to deselect and border select. And increase the value. Alright, so now the outside is done. Let's do the inside. Hit A to deselect, hit B for border select and select the upper part. Hit E to extrude and S to scale, like this. Go back to front view and go to wireframe mode. Hit E to extrude and Z to extrude along the Z axis. Press S to scale, like this, and extrude again on the Z axis. And scale. Like that. Now press E to extrude, S to scale, and 0 to fill that gap, and enter to confirm. and press remove doubles. So now the model is done, so I'll go back to solid view and go out of edit mode. Now in shading, select smooth to make it nice and smooth. Go to add mesh and select plane. Scale that. Now we have zero on the numpad, go to camera view. Now as you can see, our glass is way too big. So select it and hit S to scale. I think about 0.5 might be alright. Now go to front view and move the glass on top of the ground plane. Like that. Go back to camera view. Now give your glass the material that's over here. And press use node. Change the fuse to glass. Now make some duplicates. Press Shift D. Enter to confirm. And use the arrows to move them around. One goes over here. And another one, Shift D. This one goes over here. Now also give our ground plane a material. So select it. Press new and change the color to a more brownish color. I think this will look alright. Maybe a bit darker. Now also go to your world settings. Select use nodes. And change the color to a lighter gray. Something like this. Alright. Now go to view. And select lock camera to view. So now you can move the camera along with the view. I think this will look nice. Now go to render view. You can do that over here. This way you get a nice preview of what the final render will look like. Now go to your lamp and go to the settings. Press use nodes and decrease the strength to about 500. Now everything looks alright. So I'm now going to hit a render button and I'll see you right back when this render is finished. So here is the result. I did use 500 samples to render this. It took about 22 minutes. I hope that this tutorial was any helpful for you. Feel free to leave a comment and maybe I'll see you next time.